Jennifer Sneeden has three books already published, and one she's going to share with us today and give us an opportunity to actually get it for free. So just for those who just logged on, once again, I'm Shelvy Live, totally excited to just get to know Jennifer, get a few tips. And this woman has three books already out. She's a professional business and a trainer, does live events when there's no COVID around the country, helping business owners and people that are based in any sales-based business with getting their clients. She's someone that has walked the walk and truly has a step-by-step analysis. This isn't just for therapists. I read this book and I immediately thought, gosh, you know, honestly, this could be for any of my friends that are in business or not, that just want to have a step-by-step process, a very easy, quick guide on how to get from point A to point B. So let's give it up for Jennifer Sneeden. Hi, Jennifer.
Thank you. I am so excited to be here, Shelby. You know, I love your work. I love your energy. And when you asked me to be part of this, I was just beyond thrilled. So thank you so much for this opportunity.
It's a great opportunity to get the word out, because really the more we can kind of spread the word and give people some tips and direction, the more everyone thrives. And I know you and I are both on like a 360 win. Like, we want to share what we've learned with people, and we want to see them succeed and just really connect with more people.
Absolutely. Sure. I am such a firm believer that we have to all win, right? This can't be, I win at the expense of another person. It has to be that we all win. And I, business owners, we have such a profound impact in the world that we don't even realize. And when we can build successful businesses, we help our families, we help our team, we help our communities, we help our clients. Like, we make such a difference in the world, and we can never lose sight of that, because our little business that we think nobody knows exists impacts so many lives and has the potential to impact so many more. And so I am absolutely all about 360 degree success. Like, let's all play a bigger game, and that's how we ultimately change the world.
I love it. I love it. So for me, when I read this book, and I'm just about done, it was a wicked quick read, which I love, because I mean, this was, first of all, it was really cute the way it was written in the beginning. It got me totally pulled in, made me feel like you were talking to me, which I really appreciate, because I'm much more of a conversational book reader. I like to read what is easy to read and not something I have to reread because it was complicated. Do you know what I mean?
Like that. Absolutely. I'm all about make it simple, make it easy to digest, and then give me something that I can go do. You know, my three books I go back to over and over and over again are each like 30 pages, right? And there's so much packed into that tiny little space that I can easily go find what I need and get on with my life. So I love that I was able to do that in this book as well.
Yeah. When I first initially got introduced to this book and you know, from the title, it was just such a great title, because attracting clients in uncertain times, where it is uncertain times. If there were any, you talk about 2007, and I want to be like, ha,
right,
2007
right.
Was nothing, baby.
It was nothing compared to this. I know.
Right. But it is uncertain times. And I think this is the question on most people's minds. How do you continue to do your work and help people during uncertain times? So that to me is really valuable. And I noticed that you specialize in therapists, which I have quite a few friends, close friends that are therapists. So I thought, oh, well, this would be great for them. However, when I read your book, yes, it would be great for therapists and coaches, but I honestly felt more like this would be great for anyone trying to figure out a new direction, a new path, and didn't have the roadmap. So when I went to the Tony Robbins Ultimate Power, and when I read Jack Canfield's Principles of Success, which I totally recommend, but it's like this thick, and Wayne Dyer, who you love and I love, you'll see it when you believe it. That was my first entry to any of this personal development thing. Up until then, anybody that I knew in my life, which was very small in Massachusetts, if I mentioned any of those names, they would either say, I don't know them, or that's some motivational speaker.
And right, like, right,
oh,
right.
Gosh,
my introduction was Zig Ziglar.
Zig Ziglar.
Oh my God. Once you get the idea of, I have the power to change my life. Like, I'm not at the mercy of my life, but I actually have the power to create it. Whether it's Jack Canfield or Wayne Dyer or Zig Ziglar or Tony Robbins, when you're first introduced to that idea, it's like, holy cow.
It's like a light bulb goes off, isn't it?
Yes.
When I read that first book and got it turned into that, these ideas, my first thought was, wow, this isn't something I've ever been taught before. And it is
right.
Something you need to be taught, or you have to be in a family environment that teaches you. Like, my son's super lucky. Your kids are super lucky because we already instill this kind of belief system, and we make him do vision boards, and we get on our motivational, write down what your direction is. But my parents had no idea. And it showed clearly from how they lived their lives. They did not end up having magnificent endings and crescendos. It was actually very sad for me.
Can I just talk about those for a second?
Yeah, absolutely.
I think there's been a real generational shift that truly I hope continues, because I think the majority, I'll speak for me and the majority of my clients, and maybe the majority of your audience, Shelby, we were instilled survival skills growing
yes.
up, right? Like, save every penny, do it yourself, get a job. I remember, oh my gosh, I started my first business when I was 26. My poor grandmother was terrified for me. You have a job, why would you leave it, right? And so I think we had all of these generational survival skills that truly kept our family alive for generations. And now we're in a place that we've never been before, where we don't have to think about survival on a daily basis. And the skills that we were taught that helped our families survive are no longer serving us in the way they served our grandparents, our great grandparents. And as you said, it takes a very conscious awakening to say, I want success skills.
I want something different. Yeah.
Yeah. Like, somewhere along the line, that innate knowing that we come with, I believe we come here programmed to succeed. And our job then is to get rid of all those lies, whatever lie we chose to believe about ourselves, and get back to who we were born to be, which is incredible, successful people.
I had to read something like this in order to learn that
yes.
there was a different way of thinking.
Yep.
And I mean, I coach people with nutrition and fitness all the time, and what they think they know, clearly they don't, because 40% of our population is so unhealthy that they're on drugs, for weight related issues. And so I know, I went to school for it. That was actually my biggest thing. I wanted to understand how to be fit. And so I went to school to get my physiology degree, because what I was learning wasn't working, but I had to go to school to learn it, and that's what I feel like with these books. Like, you shouldn't think you should know it all. You got to go to other people and get coaching and get direction of people that have already walked that walk and succeeded
yes.
at it,
Oh my gosh. I remember when I was really struggling with my business, I scraped together $300 for my first coach. And Shelby, can I tell you, I had to put it on two different credit cards, because I couldn't put $300 on one credit card. And I was terrified. And from 1 hour, that's all I could afford to buy, 1 hour with this business
wow.
coach. And it changed my life and it changed my business. And that's ultimately why I started doing what I was doing, because I really saw there are so many people like me that didn't come into business knowing what to do, right?
Well, exactly.
You're a great therapist, you're a great nutritionist, you're great whatever you are. And then it's like, wait a minute.
But the recipe seems to always be the same, which is define what your goal is, your roadmap. And today you were doing an incredibly great Facebook Live that I hope I jarred something in you to do something like that, because that was so powerful and easy to understand. You went into you need an actual roadmap. You need to know where you're going. And when we hear we need to know where you're going, I don't know, that used to frustrate me, because
I know,
I don't understand that, right? But you put it in you put it in bullet points and a really concrete way for regular people like myself and need to know where you're going and what that means is in this book. She bullet points examples like, what exactly do you want to achieve? What kind of car do I drive? What kind of office do I have? What will my business life look like? Do I have employees? How do I interact with my kids? Where do I vacation? How much money do I make per year? These examples of questions, so simplistic, but most of us cannot get from what do I, where am I going to actually those steps. So for me, this book is a great entry for anyone and you're offering it for free. So I think that that's insane. You just go to her website and it's in this link there. Just check it out. But you could just pay the $5 shipping and handling and you get the book. I don't know that I could give anyone a better deal. I don't think you could. So tell me a little bit more about why you gave it for free because it's very valuable.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that very much. When schools closed last year, March 13th, March 17th, somewhere in there, the first thing I did was panic. Oh my gosh. Like life as we know it is over. And I went into pure panic mode and I allowed myself like 3 days of that. And I woke up one morning and I said, Jennifer, get over your damn self. And, the next thing I said was, if I'm freaking out, so are all of my clients.
Right.
So is all of my community. They're all freaking out. So what can I offer them that is going to get them out of freak out mode? Because you know, Shelby, as a business owner, freak out mode is not the place that you want to be, right? You've got to be in that inspired place of creation and possibility. So I had been actually working on this book a lot in 2019, and I couldn't finish it. Like it just wouldn't complete for me. And now, and I know this is like totally hokey, but now I know why. Like right. I was writing this. And then when the pandemic hit, within probably 3 weeks, I glued myself to the keyboard. I finished it. I got it published. I got it out because I believe we need to take care of ourselves. We as business owners have a very important role to play in the world. Whatever that business is, I believe so strongly in the work of small business. And you've got to be able to get yourself out of freak out and into inspiration and creativity and innovation. And so my goal really was, I want this in as many people's hands as possible. I'm not trying to make any money off the book, but I want people to feel like they've got the tools. They've got a place that's going to get them back into creativity, back into, I can do this. And that's why I, as many people as I can send this book to, truly, I'm happy to do that.
Yeah. And you do get to a place of being able to give more when you have more. And I think something you touch upon for therapists specifically, especially my friends that are therapists, what I find is they have, we all have different degrees of different personality types, right? And so therapists are generally what we call the blue color. They're very empathetic. They want to give, give, give. They're not looking for much in return, but then you have that whole conundrum of how can you fill anyone else's cup if your cup isn't full first.
Yes.
So the interesting part about the therapy is you mentioned that some of them feel guilty when they're doing well, which I have found in my friends that are therapists, a few of them do. And they want to help everybody, but they don't help themselves business-wise. And, right. And it sounds, because you're also in the industry, you can really understand that and help them develop a good business plan and help more people. And it's okay to be successful during the pandemic.
Yeah. And I think that's an important piece. It is okay to be successful during the pandemic, unless you are taking money from people and not giving anything in return. If you are making money in service of others, you have an obligation to be successful during the pandemic. One of my favorite stories, which I think came after the book, so it's not in here, a consignment shop in Atlanta, Georgia, was like their business just died, right? Who, they were closed. They couldn't even let people in. And it's a mom and her daughter's like, okay, there goes our whole livelihood. And what they took from that is how do we innovate? How do we get into a whole different place? Which this is definitely something that I talk about in the book as well. And what they did, Shelby, they started doing every week Facebook Live fashion shows where the mom and her adult daughters would, whatever clothes they had in the store, they would put together this fabulous outfit. They're not models, right? They're just women running a consignment store that want to keep their business afloat and want to help their customers. So they ended up getting people all over the world watching these weekly Facebook Live shows and selling out of inventory.
Wow.
And I'm brilliant. So inspired by that, because how many people have said, I'm going to lose my business. And these women said, we're not going to lose our business. We're going to figure out how to keep it. And that to me is the mindset that we all need to have right now.
And you mentioned that right in the beginning, you have to make a decision, make a choice. I don't want to give away everything in the book because I want them to get the book, and it's not even going to cost them anything except for shipping. So they should just go to the link and get the book. I'm going to keep that a secret, but I will ask you a few questions before we end. What do you think differentiates the successful from the unsuccessful business during times like this?
Well, it all starts with making that choice, because when you're saying to yourself, when I was in those freak out moments, those freak out days, I was saying to myself, is my business even going to make it? And when you're in that place, you're in a very disempowered place, right? You're not tapped into your inspiration. You're not tapped into your creativity. And the decision starts with, I am going to make this work. We had our largest revenue event of the year was a live event scheduled for the end of March. We pushed it to the end of April, then we pushed it to October, and then we just said, forget it. We got to figure out something else, right? I couldn't afford to let my business tank because I couldn't hold this live event. And so it starts with the decision that my business is going to succeed. And then once you make that decision, the question I really want you to ask yourselves is, how do you go from why I can't to how I can, right? So I could have easily said, well, my business is going to take a really big hit because I can't hold a live event and I can't put 100 people in a room in Philadelphia and I can't. But once I made the decision that I was going to, I said, how can I? Like, what can I do to put this online? And how do you run an online event? So just asking yourself, how can I?
Yeah, how I can instead of why I can't.
It changes so much.
It does. You know, how should businesses be marketing differently during these uncertain times?
Yeah. So in the book, I have a whole bunch dedicated to this, but let me give you one little piece here. The piece that people need now more than ever is personal connection, right? And we now need to be looking at how do we humanize our relationships with our clients? And that can be as simple as, you know, we're all working from home, sharing pictures of you working from home and what life is really like, to your own struggles. But people need connection now more than they ever did, right? You and I ran into each other a few weeks ago and I was like, oh my gosh, somebody I know.
So excited, that was so nice. Right? That was a very nice surprise.
Yes. And everybody is desperate for that. So how do you humanize yourself and humanize your business no matter what your business is? Because people are desperate for connection. And if you can connect, you've got this.
I love it. It's really powerful stuff. And I think what you're doing is amazing. And I also think it's an incredible journey to go on to help therapists. As I said, the blues
of the color scheme. And how funny that I'm wearing blue today.
Like the more you get, the more you can give. That's always been one of my basic primary goals. Like I always want to be successful, not just because I want to be successful, because that way I can help other people and I can put money and energy and time into things that are, I think, incredibly valuable, whatever that be for the for people at a disadvantage, for dogs, which I'm a little bit partial to. If you're doing well, you can share, just like when you're doing well, you can share the book. So thank you so much for sharing the book, Jennifer Sneeden.
Thank you.
You can find her on jennifersneeden.com or check out those links. There's a free book link in there. I absolutely recommend that you get it. Next week, we have Anya, and she is going to be giving us more information about her new book. It's been exciting to see so many of my very, very good friends that are doing writing books. And the reason is because of the pandemic. So another silver lining here, if people had time, they were locked up. So Attracting Clients in Uncertain Times by Jennifer Sneeden, highly recommend it. I'm Shelby. You're fabulous. Bye-bye. And don't forget, I want to connect on social with you. Facebook, Shelby Frenette, ShelbyLive.com. And we have Instagram, Solo Travel Expert. And of course, Solo Travel TV, YouTube, and LinkedIn, Shelby Frenette. I'm Shelby. You're fabulous. I'll see you on social.